And so Christ did that for us. He set us free from that curse. Christ gives us the desire to love others, which, as Scripture says, is the fulfillment of the law. The one who loves fulfills the law. And the law, Romans 1, chapters 1 and 2 says, is written on our hearts. We desire to do the commandments not as a means of salvation. We can't get right with God through the commandments. But we do them out of love for God. So even though I've been set free from the law, even though we've been set free from the law, we see in the law it says, do not murder. Now clearly, it doesn't mean that, oh, I've been set free from the law, so I'm going to go murder. No, that's foolish. That's not loving. The one who loves fulfills the law. So out of love for God and out of love for others, I don't kill people. Out of love of God and love for others, I don't steal. I don't want to covet. I don't want to put anything above God. Now again, we are sinners. We are flawed human beings. So when I continually put things above God, He gives grace. That's the beauty of the gospel. He gives forgiveness. And He cultivates that desire in me to love Him more and more. And in those times I fail, He picks me back up and He cultivates that desire in us. So lastly, please do not misunderstand me. The law is good, and Scripture says so, but we do not need to live by it in order to be saved, because we can't. Jesus Christ sets us free from the law so that we can love God and love others more effectively. So let me pray. We'll go before this God. Gracious and heavenly, powerful, holy, perfect, intimate God, we thank you for who you are. We thank you that you invite us up to the mountain that we had no access to, but now, like Moses, we can go and be with you and meet with you, God. And that is an honor and a privilege that may we not take for granted. Lord, we love you. Thank you for what you're doing in our lives. Thank you for who you are. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Amen.